This is the BTR-4 armored personnel carrier, constructed at the Kharkiv-Malyshev plant. It has started producing hulls for these vehicles. Among their main features are reinforced seams and protective plates. Now the vehicle is undergoing final endurance tests.
We've passed all the testing, like the hydrostatics testing. At the factory, we have the whole preparation for production, and we could perform all this work in-house. We've passed the ballistic armored testing at the shooting range without a hitch, and now the final stage of testing, putting mileage on it. We need to cover around 500 kilometers in testing.
Increasing the production of new armored personnel carriers is the task of the Ukrainian Defense Ministry. Its head Stepan Polturak came to the plant to check if it's ready to fulfill contracts.
I have zero doubt that the state defense contracts will be executed. I'd like to note that over the past several years, the Kharkiv region received around 10 billion of financial resources from the Ministry of Defense for the production, repairs and upgrades of armored vehicles for the armed forces of Ukraine. I saw a great deal of change in the equipment used. Equipment from Germany and Sweden allows us to make very high quality products. The quality level of machinery that is sent to the armed forces of Ukraine is considerably higher than that in 2014.
The engineers of the Kharkiv Machine Building Design Bureau have also presented a simulator of the BTR-4. They are used for training Ukrainian soldiers. Every year, the simulators are modernized.
We are working in cooperation with leading specialists in software development. This allows us to reproduce battlefield situations more realistically. This year, we've done the work to combine the simulators to do simulation training with missions performed by three crews working together.
The minister will also visit other defense institutions located in the Kharkiv city and region. Reported by Yulia Kryuchkova, UATV.